So good evening. Today we will solve the problem of gantry girder. In this we have that is capacity of crane 175 kN span between the rails 20 meters, weight of crane girder 150 kN, weight of crab and electric motor 30 kN, minimum hook approach we have 1 meter, wheelbase 2.6 meter, span of gantry girder 7.5 meter and self weight of rail 0.2 kN per meter. So now loads we have already seen whatever loads we have that we have to consider. So now weight of crab plus lifted load we have that is 30 plus 175 that will give us 205 kN which will be at hook approach from reaction. And then we have weight of crane girder. It is actually UDL and total load is given which will act at center, and from this we are going to calculate wheel load. So we have this will be the this will be the condition of hook approach and total load of the crane girder, and from this we will get value of RA. We will take moment about B0 gives me value of RA 269.75 kN. Impact load actually we have to consider 25% of weight of crab and lifted weight lifted by crane. So we have this value 2.25 into 269.75. So total load we have that is on wheels. We have two wheels because on each gantry girder two wheels are there and this load will be shared by two wheels. So we have vertical load that is 269.75 plus 67.44. And this 337.19 kN will be on two wheels, which will be 168.60 kN. And then factorial wheel load we have 252.9 kN. In step two, we have maximum shear force and bending moment. So for maximum shear force, we have to first find out self weight of gantry girder total load upon 250, which will be 2 kN per meter. Total load, we have two wheels. So 2 into 252.9 plus 0.2 into 7.5, this is weight of rail. So this is self weight of rail. And then from this loading condition, if you will see, we are in this way. So one of the wheel load we have that is on the support. And from this, we are going to get a reaction that is R1 and R2. So we will take moment about R20, and from this we will get R1 into 7.5 minus 252.9 into 7.5 due to this 252.9, then minus 252.9 into 4.9 due to this, and then due to self weight of girder WL square by 2. And from this we will get value of R1 426.39 kN, which will be maximum shear force. Then for maximum bending moment, we know one of the wheel and the center should be equidistant. So we have center that is 505 per center 1.3 from one of the wheelbase, and total load we have 505.8. So this distance we have 1.3 meters. And this wheel load and one of the wheel should be equidistant. Means if you will see, so I have this distance at 0.65. And again, this distance also we have 0.65. And then we can find maximum bending moment on one of the wheel, that is 252.9 kN. Now we will take moment about R10. So we have R2 into 7.5 minus 505.8 into 7.5 minus 3.1. So we have this distance. So this distance we have 7.5 minus 3.1. And then minus 2.2 into 7.5 square by 2. I have not considered these two loads separately, that is wheel loads. I have directly taken resultant of these two. Then we have R2 304.99 kN. R1 we will get 217.31 kN. And from this, we have maximum bending moment under the wheel load will be 217.31 into 3.1. So this distance we are going to get 3.1 meter because 3.75 minus this 0.65. And that comes 3.1 meter, gives me 663.09 kilonewton meter, which will be my maximum bending moment. And then lateral load we have, that is 10% of the crab and lifted and weight lifted, and that will be 20.5 kilonewtons transfers to the rails, that is along YY direction. Factorial lateral load, we will multiply it by 1.5, 30.75 kilonewton, and this will be on four wheels, which will be 7.69 kilonewton on each wheel. And then horizontal reaction due to lateral force. that will be lateral force into reaction due to vertical force divided by V load due to vertical load. Means we are going to calculate these values compared with your vertical loads. And from this, we will get this horizontal reaction as 9.27 kilonewton. And then maximum bending moment, again, we have due to vertical load 663.09 for 252.9 as V load. So for 7.69 load, so this 7.69 load, bending moment will be 20.16 kilonewton, which will be my value of MY. So this will be MY value. Then we will go section modulus required. So now I will not go in detail. So we know this ZP required, we have calculated. This is most important. Depth of section you have to consider, which will be depth of beam section. And from this selection of section, let us, we will go first ISWB 550 at 1037 Newton per meter, having these properties of the section. This is trial section we are considering, and we have taken ISLC 300 at 331 Newton per meter. Here we require value is 4084, but try to understand when we will go for this, then my value of channel section, so this will be YY channel and this will be ZZ channel. So we have to consider this as YYY. So we have this will be AIXX and then total area, YY of beam, and then we have to consider ZZ of channel, and ZZ of channel we have to consider YY of ZZ of beam, we have to consider YY of channel. So these two are important one. Now if I will plot this, then we have this will be channel section, and for channel this will be ZZ and this will be YY for channel, and for beam we have this will be ZZ, so Z for beam, and this vertical will be YY for beam, Y for beam. So that combination we have to keep in mind. So while we are going to calculate the total value, so we have these are the properties of the channel section. Then IYY total. Now we know to find value of FBD, we require KL upon R minimum, and R minimum we have always RYY. And therefore, we have to find out value of RYY, and this RYY that is equal to under root of I by A. And that we will calculate IYY total, we will have 3740, which will be IYY of beam plus 6070, which will be IZZ of beam, IZZ of channel. Because we know along ZZ, we have channel of, along YY, we have ZZ of channel. So this is ZZ of channel. And from this, we will get this total value as 9810 into 10 raised to 4. And then we will calculate, actually we will go for classification of section, and we have beta B that is equal to 1. Then we have calculated value of RYY, and that value we are going to get. Now you can see we have this value of IYY that is 9810, and total area if you will see, we have 18520. And by this, we are going to get value of RYY. And that value we have 72.78. And then KL upon R, we have K1, we have considered L, we have 7500, that is span of gantry girder. And HF upon TF, D minus TF upon TF. So this 556.7 minus 17.6 upon 17.6, this comes 30.63. And then by this, we are going to calculate that FCRB value as same as unsupported beams. So for 72 and 103, so we have somewhere here. And this value we are going to consider, that value we have as 291, 270, 251, 232. And this value FCRB 103, we are going to say, so 270, 290. One. So let us, we have this will be 280 and 232, 251, we have 240. So this we are going to consider as around 260. So from this we are going to consider for 260, this value we have taken as 154. These are approximate values, and from this we are going to get FBD 154.56, and which will give me value of FBD 154.56. Now I have to find out ZP of total section, and for which I have to find out value of IP, and that we know, we have already seen in plastic section how to find this. So we know our plastic neutral axis, that will be act at plastic neutral axis acts at a by 2. And therefore, we have divided this a by 2, which will be 9260 millimeter square. And now if you will see, we have section like this. And we have this value that is of YP, that is at this distance. And from this, we are going to calculate this value of ZP. So we have this distance as 86.11. So 86.11, how we work at total area? Now we have 4211 of this. Then we have flange, that is 250 into 17.6. And then this wave portion, we have considered this value. This total we have considered YP. So this distance I will get it as YP minus 17.6, which is thickness of flange, this flange, and thickness of wave 6.7. And from this I will get this value, that is equal to YP minus 17.6 minus 6.7. And once I know YP, ZP I can find. So we have this ZP first due to compression 4211 into 86.11 minus 25.55. 25.55 we have centroid of this, so 25.55, and therefore this distance we are going to get, that is 86.11 minus 25.5 plus 250 into 17.6 of channel into 86.11 minus 6.7 we have, that is thickness of wave of channel, and minus 17.6, that is of this flange, and then we have plus 10.5 into, so this distance, which is 86.11 minus 17.6 whole square by 2, and that we are going to get this value of ZP. Actually here we have to subtract thickness of wave also, minus 6.7, but that was not considered. And then this will be for bottom part, that is 250 into 17.6 into 556.7, which will be our total height, minus 86.11, which will be value of YP, means bottom portion. So if I have YP below this, then I have this distance. So we are calculating till center of this. And this distance we have 556.7, minus YP we have 86.11, and then from this center, so we have minus 17.6 by 2. This 550 we have a beam, plus 6.7 we have thickness of wave of channel, this thickness, and therefore this goes 556.7, and from this we will get ZP, that is equal to 3699.59, and from this we will get value of MD 573.34, which will not satisfy our criteria. And then we will select ISWB 600, and we have properties of this section likewise. Now I will not explain this. So we know we will calculate IYYT, then RYY, then we will get KL upon R, HF upon TF, and then we have actually here considered exact value center to center. So we have 23.6, that is of channel, that is of beam, plus we have of channel, this value we have 6.7. And then from this we have considered at center to center, and plus 23.6, and we have taken half of this, and that comes 25.8, which will give me 24.15. Then we have calculated value of KL upon R, HF upon TF, and 20 and 25. And from this we will get value of FCRB1, FCRB2, that is 297.2 and 257. 0.36, because now you can see this KL upon R 106 and HF upon TF 24.15, and for this we have these values of FCRB, and from this FCRB we have calculated value of FBD, that is by interpolation. Now exact values we have calculated, which comes 157.51 MPa, and now we have calculated same way, that is value of YP, which comes 135.38, then ZP we have calculated, which comes 5111.85 into 10 raised to 3 millimeter cube. So this portion, this is of ACYC. So this upward portion is AC into IC, and bottom portion we have AT into YT. That you have to go through any book, you can be in position to calculate it. This gives me MD value 805.17 greater than 663.09 kilonewton meter. So this is my value of MDZ and this is my value of MZ. Then we can have check for biaxial bending. So we have ZYT. Now we have to consider IYY of beam, which will be half, plus IXX of channel section. So that already we have seen. And from this, we are going to get value of ZYT. That comes 581.33 into 10 raised to 3 millimeter cube. And this will be my value of MD. Now I can say MDY. And this value MDY, we will have 132.18 kilonewton meter. And then we have to check it for biaxial bending, and this comes 0.98, which is less than 1, and therefore safe. Likewise, we have to go this problem of gantry girder, which we have to solve in term work also. So today we will stop here only. Thank you.